Okay, coming to the construction point of view, the DC motor construction which is similar to the DC generator. Okay, already we are before telling. Okay, so coming to the here, the direction of rotor which is anti-clockwise direction, already we are discussing. Okay, so according to the Fleming left hand rule, how can the direction of rotor which is anti-clockwise direction, how it is possible? So that can be generally we can practical point of view we are learning here. Okay, if you observe this diagram, you can clearly understood. Okay, this is the stator poles and this is the rotor pole. Okay, here the flux which is always flows from north pole to south pole. Okay, if you are for example considering one magnet, if you want to take one magnet, the flux which is flowing from always from north pole to south pole. Okay, so this is the representation of flux. Okay, so these are called as main field poles. So this is called as rotor armature. Okay, so the flux which is always flows from north pole to south pole like this. Okay, so here rotor is there. Okay, the rotor may contain in practical point of view, if you want to go for like a industrial purpose or like a so agriculture purpose or domestic purpose, the rotor in practical point of view, the if you break that particular rotor, the rotor may contain in practical point of view, the rotor may contain number of slots. Okay, so in practical point of view, the rotor may be like this. Will be appearing look like. Okay, so here this is the rotor. The rotor may contain number of slots. Okay, so these are the number of slots. Okay, each slot may contain one copper coil. Okay, so this is the number of slots. Each slot may contain one copper coil. Okay, all copper coils which is connected to each other. Okay, so here all copper coils which is closely connected. Okay, here closely connected to each other like this. Okay, here so total will be actually acting as a like a closed loop path. Total all armature coils which is here act as a like a closed path. Okay, already know that the current which is always flowing from in closed loop circuit. Okay, in open loop circuit there is no current flowing. Okay, so this is like a here acting as a like a closed loop path. In this closed loop path, so whenever electrical supply is given to the rotor, then the flux will be existing. Due to that flux, some resultant force will be existing. Due to that force, the rotor will be rotating. Why? Because this is like a all coils which is acts as a like a closed loop circuit. Okay, here the group of number of armature coils which is connected to each other is called as armature winding. Okay, so next one, so coming to the construction here, so first of all, okay, so how, first of all, so many people's maybe so thoughts, so there are different types of doubts, how do the rotor which is rotating anti-clockwise direction in practical point of view, so many may contain there are different types of doubts. Okay, so here simply you can understood according to from this diagram representation. Okay, so here first of all, so coming to the always the flux which is flowing from north pole to south pole. Okay, already know that here. So coming to north pole, so here we are taking to the one rule for the consideration. Okay, so that is rule name is corkscrew rule. Screw rule. Okay, here generally we are taking to the rule as corkscrew rule. Okay, corkscrew, corkscrew rule. Okay, here we are taking the consideration for the how to the rotor which is rotating in anti-clockwise direction. This is the best scientific reason which is rotate to the rotor which is rotating in anti-clockwise direction. Okay, how to rotate the anti-clockwise direction, just now we have to see here. Okay, so first of all, if the screw is, so this is, let us consider this is like a screw. Okay, if the screw is fitted,
then the current, how the right direction, how it will be rotated in the current direction? The current at the time generally which is clockwise direction. Okay, whenever the screw is fitted, okay, if you want to, for example, fitting the screw here like this in, so if you observe this handle moment, which is rotating clockwise direction, so then the current which is flowing from this side, of the rotor here, okay, so current will be flowing like this, okay, and whereas whenever current flowing through the conductor, then the flux, some flux will be existing on the entire rotor, so flux producing means itself in the rotor may contain number of armature coils. Okay, so this representation is equal to the this rotor. Okay, in practical point of view, like this. Okay, the rotor. Okay, so coming to the, when our current flowing through the conductor, so from this side only, why? Because if the screw is fitted, means which is in contains clockwise direction. Okay, then the current will be flowing like this. Okay, so then the flux which is flowing same direction, whenever the current flowing to the same direction, at the same direction may contains flux also existing. Okay, here flux will be flowing like this. Okay, so already, so whenever supply is given to the field poles, then the flux is already existing in that both north pole to south pole, then north pole to south poles, the flux will be always flowing. So these are called as main field flows, main field flux will be existing in that particular poles. Okay, already the main field flux which is coming from north pole to south pole, the main field flux will be coming like this. Okay, whenever the current will be flowing like this direction, so if you observe this diagram, you can clearly understand. Okay, if you are observe this diagram, you can clearly understand. Okay, in practical point of view. Okay, why the rotor which is rotating anti-clockwise direction, that problem can be, here we can clearly understand. Okay, so from this instant of time, okay, so if you observe the half part of the rotor, okay, so the flux direction, the main field flux direction as well as the rotor flux direction, which is always same, collide to each other. Okay, so this is the main field flux like coming like this, as well as this flux is coming like this, residual flux will be colliding. Okay, residual flux will be colliding. So the total, if you observe the half of the rotor flux, the total flux will be zero. Why? Because so one flux, main field flux to rotor flux, which is colliding to each other, resultant flux is, the flux will be weakening on half side of the conductor. The resultant flux will be weakening at the half side part of the conductor. So this is the zero. So if you have the remaining half part of the conductor, here conductor means rotor. Okay, please clearly understood. Okay, so if you have the remaining half side of the conductor, the main field flux which is coming like this, this is the main field pole. Okay, so this is north pole and this is south pole. Okay, so the main field flows which is coming from north pole to south pole. Okay, so here if you have this flux direction, main field flows as well as rotor flux, main field pole flux as well as rotor flux which may contain same direction. Okay, so this flux may contain same direction, so resultant flux will be maximum this side. So if you observe the right side half of the conductor, the maximum flux will be existing. Okay, so here the total flux will be evening. Left side of the conductor as well as right side half of the conductor, maximum flux will be existing. Okay, here, so here maximum no flux will be existing, here no flux will be existing. Okay, this condition, for example, if you want to take the best example here, so here the flux will be, so which way generally, which is passing, so that can be clarified. Best example generally we are taking, already know that, for example, let us consider water. Okay, the water which is always flows from, already know that I think the water which is always flows from higher level to lower level okay higher level to lower level the water which is flows from higher level to lower level okay not lower level to higher level okay at the same time here total flux will be weakening outside of the conductor as well as right side maximum flux will be existing so then resultant flux which way are generally passing, which way are generally passing. So the always these flux will be passing from right side to left side of the conductor, from right side to left side of the conductor, from right side to left side of the conductor, the total flux will be flowing like this. Okay, so whenever the flux will be flowing from right side to left side, then the force will be existing. Why? Because residual flux, some force will be existing. So the whenever the flux which is moves from one place to another, force resultant, some internally may contain some force also existing, some force also, okay, existing some force also. So that's why the whenever the flux is rotating will be coming like this from right side to left side, then the resultant force also existing pushing to from right side to left side, okay, right side to left side, okay. So this instant will be occurring at one coil slot of the rotor, okay, please clearly understood. This instant will be occurring at one slot coil of the rotor. This is one. For example, let us consider this is coil 1. Let us consider this is coil 2. Okay. So let us consider this is some coil 3. And let us consider this is some coil 4. Okay. Let us consider this is some coil 5. Let us consider this is some coil 6. Let us consider this is coil 7. Okay. Like this. For example, any slot is there. So this is like a coil 7, coil 8. So there are different types of slots is there. Okay. So this instant will be occurring at coil 1. This instant will be occurring. The flux which is flows coming from right side to left side of the conductor. Okay. As well as if suppose initially screw is fitted. Okay. And again, as coming to the second rule, if the screw is loosened or losing means here like this. So please clearly understood. So what is the simple, how can we rotate the hand movement? Okay, so if the screw is loosened means, so the automatically the screw is loosened means which is anti-clockwise direction. Okay, if you are twisted there with the hand movement, which is anti-clockwise direction. Okay, the screw is loosened. Okay, so that's why, so at the time the current which is flows from like this instant, okay, which is flows from right side of the conductor, okay. Why? Because the screw is loosened means loosened. Okay, so initially the screw is fitted, the current which is flows from left side of the conductor. If the screw is loosened, next instant right, the current which is flows from right side of the conductor. Okay, the assumptions is very made important, the assumptions is very important for the consideration for the anti-clockwise direction of the rotation of the motor. The assumptions is very important according to the Fleming left hand rule, the direction of rotor which is rotating anti-clockwise. Okay, if the screw is loosened, so the current which is flows from like this, okay, why? Because from the right side of the conductor the current will be flowing, okay, at this instant the current will be flowing and right side of the conductor, so then the current or flux will be existing right side also, okay. Here the main field flux also coming like this, okay, the main field flux will be coming like this, okay, due to the so here what happened here, so the total flux will be equaling. Why? Because from the this main field pole flux as well as rotor flux, both two are colliding. So resultant total flux will be weakening right side of the conductor. Resultant total flux will be weakening right side of the conductor. Okay. If you observe the remaining offset of the conductor means left side of the conductor. Okay. So this is if you want to go from after offset of the conductor. So here the total main field flux as well as rotor flux will be same direction. This flux is same direction. So the resultant flux will be maximum. At left side of the conductor. Okay. Please clearly understood. Okay. Left side of the conductor. So here the flux is total weakening right side of the conductor, as well as here the flux is maximum at left side of the conductor. Whenever the screw is loosened. Okay. So then that was. So then what happened? Here the flux which is flows from left to right. Then the flux which is flowing from left side half of the conductor to right side of the conductor. Why? Because here total flux will be weakening according to the water flow equation. So the water which is flowing from higher level to lower level, already know that. Okay. So that's why here the total flux which is flows from left side half of the conductor to right side of the conductor. Okay. At first instant, what happened?
the flux which is flowing from right side half of the conductor to left side half of the conductor. Okay. At the same time, whenever the screw is loosened, the flux which is flowing from left side half of the conductor to right side of the half of the conductor. Okay. So that's why, so that instant, the second instant, whenever the screw is loosened, that second instant will be occurring at coil 2. That second instant will be occurring at coil 2, which is very, very important. Please understood what I am saying. Okay. So this is coil 2. Okay. So these two coils, both coil 1 and coil 2. Okay. For example, let us consider this is one coil 1. For example, let us consider this is like a coil 1. This is 1', for example. This is 1' అనుకున్నామ. So రెండు ఇన్స్టెంట్లు మనకి at a time జరుగుతాయండి. Okay. Here, those two instants will be occurring at a time. Okay. Because those slots are which is connecting internally connecting each other. Those slot one, coil 1 and coil 2, all are which is internally connected. Okay, here consideration for coil 1 and coil 2, or are coil 1 and coil 1 dash, which is at a time working. Okay, so that's why at first instant, this is at first and second instant, or are at first instant. So when initially screw is fitted as well as screw is loosened, at that instant the rotor direction, initially the flux will be existing like this, and second instant the flux will be flowing from left to right. Okay, here at the instant, the force will be also existing initially from right to left as well as from left to right. Okay. At that instant, the rotor will be rotating like this. At that instant, the rotor will be, if you observe the practical representation of rotor, at this condition, practically, the rotor will be rotating like this. At one instant, the practically rotating like this. Okay. And also, the different types of instants was there. For example, this is 1 and 2, or 1 and 1 dash. For example, 2 and 2 dash, whatever may be that, at second instant, if you want to go for the similar things also, same happened working. Okay, at second instant, same. So, whenever the screw is fitting, and as well as whenever the screw is loosened, at the same time, the flux which is flowing both directional, okay, from right to left as well as left to right. Resultant, some force also will be existing from right to left as well as left to right. So resultant, the rotor will be at second instant also rotating like this. Okay. At first instant right like this, and as well as second instant like this, as well as remaining both third and fourth and fifth, sixth and different. What are maybe that? How much may contains number of slots on the total rotor, that number of instants also the rotor will be rotating like this, anti-clockwise direction. So that's why the rotor, which is simply we can call it as rotating anti-clockwise direction, according to the flux direction or a flux existing or a flux colliding in that particular both main field fold flux as well as rotor flux, that instant will be occurring here. Okay. So this is the total working principle of DC motor, as well as, so simply we can clarify the doubt about how to rotate the rotor which is anti-clockwise direction according to the Fleming right hand rule, according to the Fleming left hand rule, we can clearly understood here. Okay, thank you very much. Thank you.